Hello friends, good evening. I am Pradeepta Kumar. Welcome to today's session. Friends, this is the tutorial number one of Jenkins tutorial series. So today's session for only introduction to Jenkins. So as you know, Jenkins is more practical, less theories. So to next session onwards, we'll learn the installations, then configurations, and the how to do set up a job. Okay, so more practical. Okay, so we'll not concentrate on theories. Okay, we only practicals, but today we'll I will give an overview of Jenkins only. Okay friends, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe now for more videos related to different cloud technologies, different DevOps tool and Linux administrations, VMware, and many more latest technologies. Okay, so let's go. So friends, in today we'll cover the Jenkins overview and history, what is continuous integrations and how it works. Okay, so friends, Jenkins is a open source continuous integration and continuous delivery tool. Okay, so what is continuous integrations? In the next slide I will explain you. Okay, so first that Jenkins was named as Hudson. Okay, so after in 2011 Oracle owned Sun Microsystem, and after some dispute happened and Hudson renamed as Jenkins. Okay, nowadays Hudson is no more, and in the popular CI/CD tool is Jenkins. Okay, so friends, what is continuous integration? Okay, why you will call Jenkins is a continuous integration and continuous delivery? So as you know, in the development life cycle, a developer generally a developer develop the code, then code will be post to a repository or a source control system. Okay, then the code will be built. Okay, then after then test cases of the tester will test, then the code will be deployed in the production. So this is the development life cycle. So though Jenkins make easy that process, that means as soon as that developer develop the push the code to the commit or commit the code and post the code to the repository, then the job which is set up in the Jenkins automatically it will be triggered, and it will start building, and then test cases will run, and that it will deploy in the respective system. Okay, this is continuous. Okay, so in a large project with many developers, commits are made many times during a day. With each commit, code is built and tested. If the test is passed, build is tested for deployment. If deployment is a success, the code is pushed to productions. That means during the build, okay, when the job will be triggered, okay, when the code will commit, and as soon as the code will commit, then job will be triggered from the Jenkins. Okay, then if the build fails, then again it will trigger a mail to the respective team to fix the issue. Okay, and if the build success, then it will deploy, then post build action will will happen, and it will deploy the code in the respective system. So it is so it is called continuously. So the development can the delivery will be faster. Okay, so as you know that we are following the agile methodology, so so development the code delivery will be faster. So in the this continuous integrations, so we use so many different tool. Okay, so first is in the continuous integration server, like in Jenkins. So Jenkins is popular, like Jenkins, then in the market you will get the Bamboo, then Cruise Control, TeamCity, and other tools. But very popular is Jenkins. So most of the companies, they are using the Jenkins. Okay, then source control tool. Okay, source control means I told you that versioning control system or repository where the developer will place the code. Then the Jenkins built a job, you know, the I know that you know Jenkins the build job will trigger and the pull the code from the repository. So there is so many version control system like, you know, CVS, SVN, Git. Okay, but most of the companies they are using the Git because Git is a distributed versioning control system. So and also build tool. Okay, so build tool like you know to code to build to build the code. So generally, so many tools available in the market. So maybe you know Make and Maven. So basically, see in the Maven is a very popular tool available in the markets. Okay, so Jenkins, then Git and Maven. These three tool are combinations. Okay, these are very popular tool most of the companies are using. Then automation testing frameworks, okay, like Selenium, Appium, Test Complete. So most of the companies they are using the Selenium. Okay, so very popular tool. So Jenkins is a continuous, so we called that's why we called as a Jenkins is a continuous integration and continuous delivery tool. Okay, then how it works. So this is the, you know, the logical diagram. So basically the developer will develop the code, then they will, you know, push the code to the versioning control system, that might be Git, SVN, CVS. Then Jenkins, you know, where we have, you know, the DevOps team or DevOps guy will set up a job in the Jenkins, okay, to build the code actually. Okay, so that how to set up a job in the next sessions, I know we'll let you know, I know I will explain you how to set up a job in Jenkins to build the code. Then once you know developer push the code to the repository, then you know the respective job will be triggered. Okay, then after that, you know, the different test cases will run for the minimum of testing. Then once build success, then the code will be, you know, the post build steps will be triggered, then the code will deploy in the respective servers. Okay, so this is the life cycle. Okay, so friends, in the next session we'll know the installation process. Okay, how to install Jenkins. Okay, then next sessions we'll learn how to set up a job. Okay, so hope you enjoy the session. Stay tuned for more videos. Thank you guys.